Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here. It's our third video on solving complicated problems involving ratios. These ones are tricky, guys, just to warn you in advance, so be prepared. However, if you draw the picture, they're not as tricky as you think. Let's get straight into it and try some of these questions. If you feel like you can, pause the video and have a go at this one. Sarah and Henry share some sweets in the ratio 7 to 6. Sarah eats 16 of her sweets and the ratio left becomes 1 to 2. How many sweets did Henry have? Right, let's draw that picture of the original situation. So I'm going to call this the before situation, and afterwards I'm going to draw the after situation. So there's the before situation. Sarah has 7 parts, Henry has 6 parts. Now, afterwards, after Sarah eats some of the sweets, she eats 16 sweets, the ratio becomes 1 to 2. Now, just think about it. Henry hasn't, or we have been told, Henry has changed nothing about what he's done, right? Henry hasn't eaten any sweets. So afterwards, we can certainly take Henry's 6 parts and preserve them. He has not, as far as we're aware, eaten any sweets. However, Sarah's eaten 16. Now, we don't exactly know how many parts that's worth, but what we do know is the ratio has now become 1 to 2 between Sarah and Henry. That means that for every one part Sarah has, Henry has 2, or the way you can think of it is Henry has double the part Sarah has. So if Henry has 6 parts, the only logical conclusion is that Sarah must have 3 parts, mustn't she? It must be the case she has 3 parts because Henry has double what she's got. Now, this is where comparing the before and after situation really helps. We are told that Sarah ate 16 of her sweets. That's the difference between the before and after situation, right? So this is what we can say. We can therefore say that this part here, you see from here to here, the change in Sarah's amount, that's 16, and she's lost 1, 2, 3, 4 boxes. So we can say that 4 parts is worth 16. 1 part is therefore 16 divided by 4, which is 4. 4 is the number that goes in each box. Now, what was the question? It said, how many sweets did Henry have? You've got to assume before. Well, Henry had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts. He had 6 multiplied by 4, which is 24 sweets, and we're done. So the picture before and after was key there. Let's try another one. Pause the video, have a go. Dan and Paul share some money in the ratio 11 to 5. Let's draw that picture. So there's the scenario, 11 to 5 there, Dan and Paul. Now it says Dan decides that that split's unfair, so he gives Paul £42 of his share to make the ratio now be 1 to 1. How much did Paul have originally? So we have a before and after situation here, just like before. So that was our before situation. Let's try and draw our after situation. Now the key is here, this is a little tip for you. When things are changing in the after situation, you don't necessarily always know how many boxes or parts you have. So let's steer clear of the individual boxes. Let me just draw a representation. Dan is going to give £42 of his share away, and it's now going to be 1 to 1. So let's draw Dan. I'm just going to draw this as a box now. Dan's giving some away, so he's obviously getting less than he had before. But the one thing he knows for sure is he knows for absolute sure that that will therefore make them have the ratio in the ratio 1 to 1. Now, I've stopped using discrete little boxes here just because I don't know how many there are. But the picture's going to help me. Let me show you how that picture's going to help me. So that's the after situation, Dan to Paul. Comparing the before and after is the key here. We know that Dan gave £42 away. So I know that Dan's amount has decreased by £42. The distance between here and here is worth 42, right? But on top of that, Paul got that £42. So Paul's has increased from where it was before here to where it ended up here by 42 as well. So in total, you can see from this point all the way to this point is 84, isn't it? That's increased 84. From there to there is 84. Well, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 boxes in the original. That's 6 parts. So we know that 6 parts must be worth 84. So to get 1 part, you've got to divide 84 divided by 6. And if you do 84 divided by 6, you get yourself 14. That tells you 14 is what needs to be in each box. Now, it said, how much did Paul originally have? Well, Paul originally had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 boxes. So Paul must have 5 lots of 14, and 5 lots of 14, working that out, is going to be equal to 70. So Paul originally had £70, and we're done. So just double check that makes sense at the end. If Paul originally had 70, right? So just say that Paul had 70. And if you did work out what Dan's was, Dan is 14 multiplied by 11. Dan's must be 154. If Dan gave away £42, he would now have 112. And if Paul increased from 70 by £42, he would have 112. That's certainly in the ratio 1-to-1. They have the same amount. Let's try another one. Based on what I've just shown you, try and do a similar thing here. So the ratio of money in Obi's bank account to Rudy's bank account is 3-to-5. Let's draw that picture. So Obi and Rudy in the ratio 3-to-5, there's the picture. Obi then puts £240 in his bank account, and Rudy withdraws £350. This meant they now had the same amount in the bank accounts. How much did Rudy have first? So we do have a before and after situation. So this is the before situation. Let's think about the after. Now, I don't know how many parts, when Obi puts in money into his account, I don't know how many parts that's worth. When Rudy takes out money, I don't know. So what? But what I do know is I could draw a picture to represent that Obi, that this is going to be the after situation. Obi's has gone up by 240, right? So Obi's, that would be it normally, and it's gone up by 240. Let's just put it up a little bit like that, yeah? And I know that Rudy's, well, Rudy's has gone down by 350. So Rudy's was over here, but it's gone down a little bit, but it's going to be the same worth as Obi's now, like that, something like that. You can't quite tell where the boxes lie. You just have to say it's something like that. So this is the Obi Rudy situation, Obi Rudy. But this is where comparing to the before and after is the key. Let's think about it. Obi put £240 in his bank account. So Obi did start off here originally. So here to here, that part is worth 240, right? Now, what we do know also is Rudy withdrew 350. So Rudy was over here, but he took out 350. So that difference there must be 350. Overall, look what's happened. The difference between here and the very end must be 240 add 350, which is 590. From here to here, add here to here. So look, we've got the picture. Two boxes in the original situation are worth 590. So two parts is 590. One part is therefore half of 590, and half of 590 is going to be equal to 295. So 295 is in each box. How much did Rudy have at first? Well, Rudy originally, Rudy has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts. So Rudy has 5 multiplied by 295. And if you work out 5 multiplied by 295, you get that Rudy's portion was 1,475, and you're done. Last question. Pause the video. Have a go. So the ratio of money in Obi's wallet to Rudy's wallet one day was 4-to-1. Let's draw that picture. So there's the original picture, 4-to-1. Now, it says Obi then spent £26 that day. Obi now had 2 less than Rudy. How much money did Obi have initially? So we have a before and after situation. Here's our before situation. Let's draw our after situation really carefully. Let's think what's changed. Obi spent money. Rudy spent nothing, right? Rudy has the same amount of money. So let's take Rudy's and leave it exactly as it was. The only thing we know is that Obi spent £26 and now he's got 2 less than Rudy. So let's draw Obi out here. But Obi has now got 2 less than Rudy. Just a little bit less than Rudy, like something like that. Now, That's all we need, because look, all we've got to do is compare before and after. This amount here is 2, because Obi has 2 less than Rudy, right? But we also know, in total, Obi spent £26 that day. So from here to the end, Obi's spending was in total 26, right? So if this part is 2, this part here must be 24, mustn't it? 2 add 24 gives us the total expenditure of 26. Now we know 24 is therefore worth 3 boxes, or 3 parts. So 3 parts is worth £24. 1 part you must divide by 3, so 24 divided by 3 is 8. 8 goes in each box. The question was, how much money did Obi have originally? Obi had 4 multiplied by 8, which is £32, and we're done. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.